Hi everyone, welcome back to Vintage. Thank you for matching my enthusiasm last week for Book of Numbers. It was great to see so many of you wanting to get hold of that copy. The lucky person who did was Jade Flynn. Jade, if you look underneath this video, you will find my email address. Please send me your postal address and I will get that book, and indeed its circular jacket poster thing off to you as soon as I can. The other book I was talking about was Stephen Witt's How Music Got Free, another brilliant book, and that copy was won by Beefers26. The same thing, if you can send me your postal address, I'll get that off to you straight away. Since recording the vlog, we've actually got an interview with Stephen up on our SoundCloud page. It's really interesting to hear him talking about where the idea for the book came from and some more about the people and the themes contained within it. So there'll be a link for that underneath this video too. It is well worth listening to. Now, this week, I'm a little bit excited. As you may remember, a couple of weeks ago, I said that I was hoping to get hold of something rather exclusive. Then it wasn't there, but now it is here. I've managed to get my hands on it. It is here. I can't even speak. I'm so excited. This is what I was talking about. This is a limited edition box set proof of City on Fire by Garth Riske-Hallberg. Now, before I get carried away and tell you all about the whole box set proofness of it, let's talk a bit about the book. Just before I started working here, I managed to get hold of a manuscript of City on Fire. It was a book that I had heard about last year because in America, the film rights to this book were sold before the book had even found a publisher, which is quite an exciting and rare thing. It did find a publisher. We will be publishing it in the UK in September. And the reason why there's all this interest is because it's a very exciting book from a very exciting writer for the future. Garth Riske-Hallberg is the editor of a website called The Millions, and he had published a very small novella previously. This is his debut novel. It is big and bold and ambitious and yet readable and engaging and entertaining and cool, actually, in a way that books often aren't. That is because it is set in New York, that coolest of cities, in 1976, 77, at that sort of very, very cool era in New York. We're talking about New York punk. We're talking about sort of unrest and a city fizzing with energy that could sort of explode in any one of a number of directions. And at its centre in this novel, there are two gunshots in Central Park. New Year's Eve, 1976, two gunshots ring out and somebody lies bleeding in the snow. Hallberg introduces you to a cast of characters who are all somehow connected to that shooting. Although to look at them, you wouldn't believe that they were connected at all. And that's because they are rich, poor, young, old, black, white. They cover the whole range of people living in New York at that time. And yet somehow they are all connected to this person at the centre. And what Hallberg does is to show you a sort of sweep of the action, and then another sweep through, and then you will find out more and more about each of these people, more and more about the mechanics of the plot, if you like, and more about what's really going on and how these people are connected. It's a brilliant way of telling what is a very thrilling story, because it's slow and meticulous, and therefore all the more engaging. It's a bit like watching a long TV series, which is where this idea for the box set proof has come from, I think. Also, the book is naturally divided into sections, and so what you can see with this proof is that those individual sections have been individually bound, and a bit like taking one of your DVD boxes out of the DVD box set, you can watch one, two, three, you can binge like I did. I read this whole thing in, I don't know, 2 weeks. It was just joyous. And each of these individually bound books, as you will see from the pictures I'm flashing up, are sort of individually designed. So you will see each of the characters that we're talking about in this novel and a quote to sort of sum them up. An amazing piece of design, this proof. It is completely gorgeous, and therefore there are very, very few of them. There are probably just over 100 of them, and I have managed to snaffle one of them because I wanted to give one away. So this is what we're here to do. You will want to read this book. One person has already said in the press, can you afford not to read this book? As I said, it's published in September, but one of you can read this book now. In fact, three of you can, because as well as snaffling this box set proof, I've also managed to grab a couple of ordinary proofs. I'm really enthusiastic about the book, and I want more people to read it and to be talking about it and enjoying it. What do you have to do to get hold of this book? You know the rules. Make sure you're subscribed. Leave a comment underneath this video and I will pick one person, one very lucky person, to win that box set proof, and two other people to win ordinary proofs. Now, because I don't have any super exciting extra content to show you about this book at the moment, because we're not publishing it until September, I'm putting a link underneath this video to another YouTube video. And this is a documentary all about New York in 1977. And it tells you about the music, about the people, and one particularly important event in the novel, which is the blackout that happened in 1977. It's really crucial to the plot, and it's I didn't know anything about it until I watched this documentary, so it's fascinating to find out more about the real events of that year, and you will get a real impression about the era and the sort of the atmosphere and the sort of culture and the excitement and the coolness that comes through this novel. It captures it brilliantly, and the documentary is well worth watching. I think that's all for this week. I think I've rattled on enough. As I said, make sure you leave a comment if you're interested in winning this book, and you should be, because it's, as I said, it's incredibly entertaining read. It's very, very ambitious in its scope. And also, it's exciting because it heralds a new writer that we should all be excited about. This is his debut work. I can't wait to read what he does next. I just hope it will be as exciting as what I've read so far. So there we go. That's this week. I'll see you next week for more. Thank you and take care.